Assalamu alaikum everyone, this is Abu Ahmed Chaudhary and welcome to our physics class. Today we are going to cover some new topics from chapter 2.07. So let's not delay anymore and let's begin.
So I would request everyone to write the chapter number and the chapter name, chapter 2.07 and solving circuits. So before starting the new chapter, I'm going to give a short revision on chapter 2.06, which is parallel and series circuit. So a short review. So first we should know that what is a circuit. A circuit is a closed path that allows electricity to flow from one point to another. A circuit is a closed path that allows electricity to flow from one point to another. A circuit is a closed loop, or another definition is a circuit is a closed loop that electrons can travel in. We have seen a circuit many times. We have also seen how does a circuit, we also know that how does a circuit looks like. We have, as I said in the previous video, that there are two types of circuit. One is a series circuit, another one is a parallel circuit. So a series circuit comprises a path along which the whole circuit, which the whole current passes through each component. Or you can write that a series circuit is one in which every component is arranged in a series connection. A series circuit is one in which every component is arranged in a series connection. Therefore, a series circuit has the same amount of current, but the voltage is shared. Properties of a series circuit. The bulbs share the voltage from the battery, so each glows dimly. If one bulb goes out or removed, or if it is broken, the other goes out because the circuit is incomplete. If one bulb goes out or removed, or if the bulb is broken, the other goes out because the circuit is broken. We have seen a sample diagram of how does a working circuit looks like, and we have also seen that how does a not working or non-working or broken or an incomplete circuit looks like. Now a parallel circuit, an electrical circuit that has two or more components that are connected in parallel. An electrical circuit that has two or more components that are connected in parallel. Or another definition is that a parallel circuit comprises or include or involve. A parallel circuit comprises or include or involve branches so that the current divides and only part of it flows through any branch. A parallel circuit comprises or include or involve branches so that the current divides and the only part of it flows through any branch. Properties of a parallel circuit. First property is that voltage or potential difference in each branch of a parallel circuit is same. The current is shared across the branches. The third property is that if one bulb goes out, the only bulb in that series will not glow, others will glow. If one bulb goes out in that series, only the bulb in that series will not glow, the others will glow. We already know that resistance equals to voltage by current. Whenever current will pass through the bulbs, it will face some resistance. Whenever current will pass through the bulb, it will face some resistance. If a bulb has a higher power, it has a lower resistance. If a bulb has a higher power, then it has a lower resistance. Now we are going to start chapter 2.07. So first I am going to write three formulas. I will really appreciate if you guys write that formulas on your note copies. So as you guys are seeing the board, I have written three formulas. The first one is resistance equals to voltage by current. Resistance equals to voltage by current. The second one is voltage equals to current into resistance. Current equals to voltage by resistance. So the main thing is that here you only need to remember the first formula or the second formula or the third formula. You can remember any one formula and you can create the other two by seeing the first formula. For example, I have only remembered resistance equals to voltage by current. I have only remembered that resistance equals to voltage by current. So now if I have been questioned that find the voltage of the battery, I have given the amount of current that passes through and the amount of current and the resistance of the battery. Now I have been said to find the voltage. I will simply subject the voltage, I will subject voltage and I will take current and resistance at one side and will subject voltage. So according to the first formula, if I subject voltage, then I have to make resistance and current stay at the same direction, right? At the same direction. If I keep voltage at the right side, I have to keep current and resistance on the left side. And if I keep voltage on the left side, I have to keep resistance and current on the right side. So I am subjecting voltage. So while subjecting voltage, the formula is given that resistance equals to voltage by current. Now I will simply multiply the current with the resistance. I will just simply multiply the current with resistance. সোজা সুজি কথা বললা আমি কারেন্টটাকে ডান হাতে এখান থেকে ভোল্টেজের সাথে যে ডিভাইডার আকারে আছে সেই কারেন্টটাকে আমি সোজাসুজি উঠিয়ে নিয়ে যে আমি রেজিস্ট্যান্সের সাথে গুণ করে দেব। গুণ করে দিলেই আই উইল ফাইন্ড দ্য ভোল্টেজ অফ দ্য ব্যাটারি। নাও ইন দ্য সেম ওয়ে ইফ আই হ্যাভ সেড টু ফাইন্ড আউট দ্য অ্যামাউন্ট অফ কারেন্ট অফ এনি অবজেক্ট অর এনি ইলেকট্রিক্যাল অবজেক্ট ইফ আই হ্যাভ বিন আস্কড টু ফাইন্ড দ্য অ্যামাউন্ট অফ কারেন্ট পাসেস থ্রু দ্য ইলেকট্রিক্যাল অবজেক্ট অর ইলেকট্রিক ইয়েস দ্য ইলেকট্রিক্যাল অবজেক্ট then what will I do? I will just subject current here according to the second formula. Voltage equals to current into resistance. Here I will just simply make current the subject of the equation and I will divide resistance by voltage. I will divide resistance by voltage from voltage. So voltage by resistance, voltage by resistance equals to current. See, these all three formulas are interrelated. So you don't need to remember all three. You don't need to remember all three. You can remember or you can learn any one and you can process the other tools. You can process the other two. And one more thing, that when we may say that three formulas or five formulas, actually for the word formulas never exist. It doesn't exist. It's formulae. Formula means one single formula, and formula means that more than one. The plural form of formula is formulae. The plural form of formula is formulae, not formulas. We generally say that formulas. এটা আমরা খালি কথ্য ভাষায় বলি, কিন্তু সঠিক নিয়মে ফর্মুলাস বলে কোনো শব্দ নাই। ফর্মুলা আছে এবং ফর্মুলে আছে। দিস ইজ এ এক্সট্রাকটিভ ফর ইউ গাইজ। নাও লেটস সি এ
example with a question, which will help us to understand the topic we are learning today better.
Now, I have written a question. Let's see the question very carefully. Let's read the question at first. First, we need to, for passing an exam or for getting a good grade in physics and chemistry or in any subject, the main thing is that we have to read the question carefully and then we have to understand that what is the question asking from us. Here, the question has given us some information. The information are that if a circuit has a current of 2 ampere, if a circuit has a current of 2 ampere flows through of a resistor, flows through a resistor. If a circuit has a, have a current, if a circuit have a current of 2 ampere, if a circuit have a current of 2 ampere flows through a resistor of 5 ohm, if a circuit have a current of 2 ampere flows through a resistor of 5 ohm, what will be the voltage across the resistor? That means that a circuit, let's imagine a circuit. A circuit, what does a circuit have? It has a battery or the power source, it has current conducting wire, an ammeter. It may have a bulb or not, a bulb is not mandatory. It has a resistor, a fixed resistor or a variable resistor. Then a voltmeter connected to the volt, connected to the resistor, or if a bulb is given, then the voltmeter is connected to the bulb. So here the voltmeter is connected to the resistor, and suppose we don't have the voltmeter right now. Even we have the voltmeter is not working. Now we are asked that what's the voltage of the resistor? What is the voltage of the resistor? That we know that the amount of current passing through the resistor is 2 ampere, is 2A or 2 ampere. The amount of current passing through the resistor is 2 ampere, and the resistor has the resistance of, and the resistor has a resistance of 5 ohm. So we are asked to find the voltage of the resistor. I hope that you guys have written the question or have taken an essay screenshot of the question right now. So I'm going to keep it for a little bit longer so that those who didn't write the question can write it on the note copy. Then I'm going to erase the question and we are going to find out the voltage, or we are going to solve the mathematics. I think this much time is okay for writing a short question like this. Now I'm going to erase the question and we are going to solve the maths. So you guys don't have to write the above thing that I have written voltage across resistor, colon, then I have given a hyphen. I have written this thing to only make you guys understand that this, the thing I am writing right now, or I have written right now, is the part, or is the part of the answer of the previous question we have seen or we have written. So we have been asked to find the voltage, and we, what will be given? That 2 ampere of current passing through a resistor of 5 ohm. So we have been given the amount of current and the amount of resistance. So we were asked to find the voltage. So we know the formula, voltage equals to current into resistance. Current into resistance. V equals to I into R. V equals to, the value of I is 2 ampere and the value of R is 5 ohm. So 5 into 2 is 10. 5 multiplied by 2 is 10. So this is the answer of the question. Now we are going to find, we are going to solve another question. So let me write it. Here we can see a diagram. A diagram of a parallel circuit. How we have understood that it's a parallel circuit? It's because it has two different branches. Because it has two different branches in two different branches, two different resistors are connected with a single power supply, there is two different resistors. With a single power supply, there are two different resistors connected in different branches. By seeing this, we are understanding that it's a parallel circuit. Now, whenever you will see this kind of circuit diagram, whenever you will see this kind of circuit diagram in an exam copy, be sure they are going to ask that what is the amount of current passing through each of the resistor. What is the amount of current passing through each of the resistor? What is the amount of current across each of the resistor? And what is the total amount of current? They will ask you two different questions. They are going to ask you two different questions. First, they are going to ask you what is the total amount of current passing through the whole circuit. What is the total amount of current passing through the whole circuit? And they are going to ask you the second thing is that they are going to ask you that what is the amount of current passing through each of the resistor or each of the branch. And the second way, they are going to ask you the same question, but there is a difference in the second question. Second way is that they are not going to give you the amount of voltage. They are not going to give you the amount of voltage. That here the question has given you that the battery has a voltage of 18 volts. There you won't be given the amount of voltage. Either you will be given the total amount of current. Then you have to find out that what is the amount of current in each of the resistor, and then you have to find the, either they will give you the total amount of current, or they in second part of question they are going to give you the total amount of current, then you have to find the total amount of voltage, or they will give you the amount of current in each of the branch, then you have to find out the voltage for each of the branch and then add the voltage. However, they will ask you the same thing. They will ask you this four thing in two different manners. There will be two different questions, two different types of questions, and four different style questions, but four types of questions. And all of the things are related to the formulas we have seen in the very beginning. Voltage equals to current into resistance, current equals to voltage by resistance, and voltage equals to current into resistance, current equals to voltage by resistance, and resistance equals to voltage by current. The whole questions will be depending on the three formulas or the formulas we have seen in the very beginning. So let's see, what is the current across the 18 volt battery? The first question that has been asked is that what is the amount of current across the 18 volt battery? I'm not going to write this thing right now. First, you guys copy the diagram and write it by your own, that what is the amount of current across the 18 volt battery. What is the current across the 18 volt battery? This is the first question. I'm going to give you some time to write it. I hope you guys have written the answer. Let me write it. Then I'm going to let me write the answer, then you guys should match the answer that you have written, that either it is matching or not. If it is not matching, then you guys have made some mistake, but nothing to worry. Every mistakes make a man perfect or makes a person perfect, as mistakes are the stairs of success. Mistakes are the stairs of success. So let's not talk anymore. Let me write it. So I have written the current across 18 volt battery. You guys do not have to write this thing, as you just need to give. They will say you that they are going to say you in a question. Either you have to write it or not. They are going to, you're going to see in the question paper. Either they will give you space. They will write the whole question together and will give you space. If they write the whole question together and then give you space, then you have to write this thing that current across 18 volt battery. Current equals to 18 volt battery. Full colon diva. Colon dite hobe. So tapor. Then you have to be first thing first, you have to find the total amount of resistance. So the total amount of resistance is, the first thing first, the total amount of resistance is 7 ohm plus 3 ohm, which is 10 ohm. So current equals to voltage by resistance. So I equals to V by R. So the 18 volt by 10 ohm gives us 1.8 ampere is the total amount of current that has been passing through the 18 volt battery. Now we are going to see the second question. So when you are asked, so for the question that has been asking us for finding the amount of current for 3 ohm resistor, we will write in this process that current across 3 ohm resistor equals to voltage by resistance. I equals to V by R. Then we are going to put the amount of voltage, which is 18V and 3 ohm. As we have known in a previous chapter that in a parallel circuit the current is shared but the amount of voltage remains the same. So the voltage of the battery is the total voltage that will be in the circuit. So 18V by R equals to 18V by 3 ohm is equals to 6. 6 to the power 6 is 18. 6 3 is 18. So 6 ampere is the amount of current. Now we are going to see the current across 7 ohm. Current across 7 ohm resistor. So now, when we are asked to find the current across the 7 ohm resistor, so we are going to use the same formula, that current equals to voltage by resistance. Current equals to voltage by resistance. So I equals to V by R. The total voltage is 18 volts and the amount of resistance by the resistor is 7 ohm. So the value comes 2.57 and more. So we can either write 2.6 ampere at 1 decimal place, or we can keep it till 2 decimal place, 2.57 ampere. So this is the answer of this question. So I hope that you guys have understand, and that is the end of chapter 2.07, solving circuits. That's the end of it. So assalamu alaikum everyone, and thank you for being with me.